Guys, and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to be explaining about why three cylinder engines are becoming more common and why it has very good characteristics which it owns, and I'm going to be explaining what are the advantages and disadvantages of these three cylinder configured engines. So let's get started with it. Now, three-cylinder motorcycles are very rare to find, and Triumph's Daytona 675 and Daytona 675R has been the most prolific and most dominant three-cylinder middleweight supersport machine which has been produced. And in this category, there has been no triple-cylinder engine, configured engine, which has been produced till now. So why it has a that very angry kind of a grunt and a very raw characteristics, because as you know, the two cylinder engines have a very good low end and the middle rev range, the power is good, but it lacks in the top end. But if you want a top end, the inline four cylinder engines produce some amazing top end, but there is no as such a power in the middle and at the lower end. So the British engineers, Triumph is a British company, so the British engineers thought about it and made a three cylinder configured engines which can combine the best of the both worlds, the good and the mid range, the good low end and the mid range of a two cylinder, and a very good top end like a four cylinder engines. So four cylinder engines can rev up to 14, 15, sometimes even 16,000 rpm, but a two cylinder engine taps out at 12, 13, maximum 13,500 rpm. So the three cylinder engine is manufactured so that it can produce best of the both worlds, because in a three cylinder engine three pistons are moving, but in two cylinder engines two pistons are moving, and in a four cylinder engine four pistons are moving. But in a two, it is much smoother than a two cylinder engine, but it is less refined compared to a four cylinder engines. I'm going to be explaining why, when it comes to the advantages of this engine, it is more fuel efficient than that big four cylinder engine, which can produce some high amount of power. The question arises is, what if the four cylinder and the three cylinder engine have the same cc? Now, if you consider a 1000 cc 4 cylinder engine and a 1000 cc 3 cylinder engine, which is going to be more fuel efficient? In that case also, 3 cylinder engines are the more fuel efficient ones, because as you know, the more number of the cylinders and more number of power it the engine produces, more fuel needed to be burned. And here one cylinder is less, so the frictional force that is acting on the crankshaft and the pistons is very less. So when the friction is less amount of power is needed for the movement of the pistons. So when less amount of power is needed, less amount of fuel is needed, and less amount of air is needed to power the engine, exactly for the same reason, for the four cylinder, more amount of air, more amount of fuel is needed for that extra cylinder to work. So that's the reason a four cylinder engine is less fuel efficient than a three cylinder engine. And one of the most important advantages of three cylinder engines are, it is a compact engine. Though a 1000 cc motorcycle of a four cylinder engine is becoming compact nowadays, but still three cylinder engine configured motorcycles are very compact in size, and compared to four cylinder engines, it is much less in weight, and the maintenance and the cost is also less. But the main disadvantage of these three cylinder engines are the refinement. It is not as smooth as the four cylinder engines, because in a four cylinder engines, the pistons are moving in a 90 degree angle. The crank is obtained in a 90 degree angle. So when you are moving a piston in 90 degree angle, so a stroke is obtained at every 90 degree. So, but whereas compare with the three cylinder engines, the pistons are have a firing order of 120 degree. So only three strokes are obtained in a single rotations, whereas compared to the four cylinder engines, four strokes are obtained in a single rotation. So in this case, I am gonna give it to four cylinder engines in terms of the smoothness, and three cylinder engines are also very smooth, but compared to four cylinder engines, three cylinder engines are a bit unrefined, you can say. So three cylinders are becoming more common because a well-known fact, or if you don't know, unless you watch this video now, the BMW i8, which is a 2.8 crores car, which is sold in India, has a three cylinder engine. It blew my mind when I heard this first when the car was released. And for 2.8 crores, man, you can get a Nissan GTR R35 in India. So compared to that, a three cylinder engine in a BMW, man, it is very disappointing actually. And the same engine is obtained in the Ford EcoSport, which is 123 horsepower, and that car is obtained like 10 to 15% of the cost of BMW i8. So that's all, guys. And if you find this video helpful, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell, so that you can get every latest update and all the automobile knowledge that I am sharing with you all, so that we can both can learn at the same time. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in my next video.